guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. Today I'm finally giving you guys the apartment tour I've been promising you. I'm giving you a furnished apartment tour today, so let's hop straight into the video. So this is what my apartment looks like when you first walk in. This entryway is a little bit smaller than my last one, so here's just the front door, and then I have a little coat closet here on the right. Nothing fancy, nothing major. Just like a little cute entryway. So I decided to put my map of full portrait here on the left side. It's just a constellation map of my birthday, and then my favorite Bible verse is on it, Romans 8:28. And yes, I really love map of full. They have really, really nice portraits and very nice custom made projects that you can do to add to your home. So I'll link that information down below. But below it, I just have a vase that I got from Home Goods. It actually was yellow, but I spray painted it matte black. And then I just put some pompous grass in it from Lux B. So this is pretty much what my little entryway first take is looking like when you first come in. And then over here on the right, I just have my coat closet, which is where I keep my trash cans and such, and cleaning products like a broom, Swiffer, and things like that. I don't like those things exposed, so I try to tuck them away in this little closet. So yeah, this is just what that looks like. It's nothing special or organized or anything like that. Moving on to this side, I did want to keep my console table because I loved it so much. I got it from Amazon, so it's low-key a little entryway, but I think I'm definitely gonna add my mirror on top of that. If y'all remember my little circle mirror I got from Target, I'll probably add that on top of the console table like my last apartment. But on this table, I just have a pedestal bowl from Home Goods. I filled it with some moss from Hobby Lobby. This lamp is from Target. I have the Homebody book from Heart the Hand Collection, and my Vitruvi diffuser, which I got from Amazon. The round circle vase is from the Project 62 collection at Target. And then I just have an electric candle lighter, which I got from Amazon. So I'll link all that down below for you guys, because this has definitely changed the game for my candle lighting. So yeah, this is just what my entryway and console area looks like. Very simple, very low-key. I love it. So moving on to the kitchen. So if you have watched any of my other apartment tour videos, my kitchen has not changed much at all. I still have all the same decor. I just switched it up because my apartment is obviously different. So over here, I have this really huge island, which I love having this big island. These are quartz countertops. Love how the white looks so clean. But on top of it, I just have my tray, which is the Lazy Susan from the Heart and Hand collection at Target. I have my Sunwash citrus candle from Bath & Body Works. This vase is from Studio McGee collection, and then the white one is from the Project 62, and I just filled it with some dry floral from Michaels. So definitely wanted to bring in some spring vibes for spring, and I'll probably change it for like every season to kind of go with what the season is at the time. So this is just what it looks like from another angle. And my bar stools are from Amazon. Love these bar stools. They aren't the most comfortable, like I told y'all before, but they're cute, so I'm sticking with them. I'm gonna stick beside them. So this is just what the overall bar area looks like. I have some really nice pendant lighting above it, which I love pendant lighting. I will always have pendant lighting in my space because I just love what it adds to it. But here is just the sink area. I have a dishwasher that I finally started using. I never would use my dishwasher before because I just never trusted them, but I finally use it and my life has changed. So I'm sticking with the dishwasher. But up here is just some lotions, hand soap, and dish soap from Public Goods. And then my paper towel rack is from Target. So love that. This marble slab tray that my soaps are sitting on is from Home Goods. These double doors are for the washer and dryer, which is nothing special at all. But here is the kitchen. So nothing's really changed. Love my espresso cabinets. Really, really nice hitting on that quartz countertop like that. Love the contrast. Over here is just my wine rack, which I got from Target. Very inexpensive. Just have a couple of different wine bottles on there. And then on the left here is my favorite cutting board. It's from Home Goods. It was really, really inexpensive as well. I believe it was like $14. And then here's just like a marble slab that you can put like your like cooking ware on there while you're cooking and things like that. I got that from Ross. So over here in this corner is just my homemade lovely book, which you can get from Amazon. I purchased mine from Target. And on the side of it, I just have this wooden bowl, which is from Home Goods, and I have some wooden beads sitting in it from the Studio McGee collection at Target. So moving on to this stove area and little coffee area, I like to call it. I just have my Studio McGee planter sitting here, which this is probably one of my favorite purchases that I've ever purchased from Target. And then I have some wooden spoons from the Hearth and Hand collection sitting in there, along with the Magnolia Table by Joanna Gaines from the Hearth and Hand. So love that combination together. And then sitting over here, I call this like the little coffee area. So I got this mug tree from Target, which is from the Hearth and Hand collection. And then the mugs are also from the Hearth and Hand collection at Target as well. This little marble muddler is from Home Goods. I've never used it still to this day. I just like the way it looks. And then I just have my Echo Show sitting here with my favorite Bible verse again, because it lives in me, honestly. So here is the Keurig. This is really, really cute and mini. Got that from Target as well. And then this is just the refrigerator area. So yeah, this is just what the kitchen looks like. Have a microwave sitting up there. And yeah, so this is it. This is the kitchen. And I really love how open an area it is in this new apartment. So definitely filling this kitchen a whole lot better than my other one. So let me know what y'all think down in the comments. So moving on to the living room, which is one of my favorite places in the home. This is what it looks like. So it's a lot bigger than my other one. So things are not fitting as great as I would like them to, especially this rug. It fit really well in my other apartment, but in this one, it looks like it's being swallowed a little bit, but I still like it. I'll probably end up getting a new one, but it'll do for now. So I really love how open this is. I keep saying that, but it's just so much different than my other apartment because light just comes in here so naturally and nicely, and it just fills the room really well. It makes a huge difference. So loving that so far. So I'm gonna tell y'all where I got everything. This sofa is from Rooms to Go. It's from the Cindy Crawford collection. It is in the color steel. It's really, really comfortable. It's been traveling with me in my last three apartments. So this is probably the last apartment it'll be in, but it's working for me for now. These portraits up here are from Desenio. They're poster prints, and then the frames are from IKEA. So IKEA has really, really nice, affordable frames. So I highly recommend checking those out. I'll link everything down below so y'all can check out the things that I have in here. These big pillows are from Amazon. They are pillow inserts, and I just got pillow covers to cover them, which are also from Amazon. So I will link that too, so y'all can check that out. Very, very cozy vibes. Love big plush down pillows. So over here is just my coffee table. This coffee table is from Wayfair. It is a huge, heavy chunk coffee table, but it's really cute, so I like it a lot. On top of it, I just have my Tom Ford book along with a crystal that I got from Home Goods. And then in the middle here is just a bowl from the Hearth and Hand collection at Target, and I just filled it with some moss from Hobby Lobby. So this candle is also from Hearth and Hand collection. I don't think they sell it anymore, but it's a really, really pretty brass color. And then I also have this candle snuffer, which is from World Market. So love, 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 love how my coffee table looks with the living room. So moving on to the entertainment center area. My entertainment center is also from Wayfair. It is a high gloss floating entertainment center with shelves, so you can open it and store things inside of it, which I really love. This basket is from Ross. It was only like $12, so that was like the steal of the year. Okay, so love that basket. It's really nice. On top of the entertainment center, I just have this head, which is from Home Goods, and then I have a Barack Obama book sitting on top of a Chanel book, which you can get these books from Amazon, Target, wherever. I have the Studio McGee knot sitting on top of those, and then over here is just a tray that I got from Home Goods. I am in love with this tray so much. It is a beautiful wooden, aged looking wooden tray. It's just gorgeous, so love that. And inside of it is a wooden bee that I got from Amazon, and the strip on the back is from Home Depot to hide the wires. So here is just a Louis Vuitton book, which you can get from Amazon or TJ Maxx. And on top of it, I just have a brass vase, which is from Target, the Project 62 collection. And then over here is just a gold cross that my boyfriend's grandmother gave him, which we will keep on display because we're just very sentimental people and we love Jesus. Okay, so over here is just a really, really nice planter that I got from At Home, which is just a steal. I got it for about $20. It is a beautiful planter, and I just have my fiddle leaf tree, which I got from QVC. It's a 6-foot faux fiddle leaf tree. I really really like it. I think it looks, you know, realistic. Excuse the moss missing from here. I have dogs that like to just throw things around. No, they do not eat it. They just throw it around and just, I don't know what the problem is. So I'm probably going to have to remove that so we don't have any problems. So, but over here is just a poof that I got from Target. Not sure how I feel about it, but I just wanted to add something because the living room was looking super empty. So the rug is from Home Goods. So the rug is from Home Goods. It was really cheap. It was only $60. It's a pretty decent sized rug. It's just not big enough for this space in particular, but really, really nice nevertheless. So this is just what it looks like as a whole. Over here in this corner, I just have my RoboVac and an air purifier. So with dogs, it's really good to have an air purifier so you can kind of like get that dog thing out of the air, you know. So really, really love that. So yeah, here's just the overall look. Let me know what y'all think about my little front area, what it's looking like, what I could add, what I could take away. Let me know what y'all think. So let's move on to the bedroom. So over here on the left side is just my bedroom. When you open the door, it's a totally different vibe than the rest of the house. This is still my glamour girl room because I'm not spending money to change this right now. So this is what it's going to be. So I really love it though. I love a light and airy white bedroom. I just feel like you just sleep better with light colors in your bedroom. I love this. So yeah, this is just what the overall look is of the bedroom. It will get changed when we move. Again, this is just what I'm going to stick with for now. So let me know what y'all think about it in the comments. So let's go ahead and talk about where everything is from. So my end table here is from Target. It is a mirrored glass end table. I really like it a lot. I know we're trying to do away with the mirrored furniture, which we will eventually, but I really like it for now. And then this lamp is from TJ Maxx. This Casa Luna room spray is probably my favorite. It smells so good. This is the Clarity room spray from Casa Luna at Target. And then I just have a Good Vibes, Good Life book by Vex King. You can get that from Amazon. This abstract art is from the At Home store. Very, very inexpensive. These pictures up here, the frames are from the At Home store. And then the portraits are from Decennio. So I'll link all that down below so y'all can check that out. My bed is from Rooms to Go. It's from the Sofia Vergara collection. My dresser does match it, so it's both from Sofia Vergara. But on top of the bed are just some really big Euro pillows, which is from Amazon, pillow inserts. This duvet is from Amazon. This little rug on top of it is from Ross. And then the two gray pillows are from Kirkland's. I'll link what I can down below for y'all so y'all can check that out, especially the Amazon stuff. Over here in this corner, I have my vanity, which is making me cringe right now because you can see all of the fingerprints on it, which is all, it's all the time, but that's what you get from mirror furniture. But this is where I do my makeup. I just have my vanity mirror, which is from Amazon, this little necklace holder, which is from Hobby Lobby, and then the stool is from Amazon as well. I just keep my makeup on there and things just get ready with in my Amazon Echo Dot. Here is just the view from the bedroom. This window is dirty, so don't mind that, but this is just what this little corner looks like too. So this is an ottoman from Home Goods with a pillow from Home Goods on top of it. This mirror is from TJ Maxx, and then I just have some little green grassy decor sitting here, which is from Burlington. And then on top of my dresser, which my dresser is from Rooms to Go, I have my TV, which I got for Black Friday. Black Friday is the best time to get a TV, y'all. This is a 50-inch, and I believe I got it for under $200, so not bad at all. And it's a smart Roku TV. Love it. Over here is just my storm candle, which you can get from like TJ Maxx or Home Goods. And then I have another tray, which is from Home Goods, that I keep my everyday jewelry in. And then this reed diffuser is probably my favorite. This is also from the Casa Luna collection in the scent Clarity. Love that. And it actually smells of the room, so it actually works. So if you're looking at that, I highly recommend checking that out. So over here is just a little perfume collection. Most of them are from Dossier. Dossier is a fragrance company that makes inspired by scents of our favorite designer designer perfumes that we love for a fraction of the price. So they actually sent me two new ones. So let's talk about them. So Dossier sent me two new fragrances that I am in love with. These two are probably my favorite that they have sent me so far. The Woody Sage is inspired by the Jo Malone's Woody Sage and Sea Salt. And then the Florence of Cedarwood is inspired by Mugler's Alien. So I love these two. I think the Woody Sage is the perfect everyday summertime beachy kind of scent. Love that. And then the Floriental Cedarwood is more of like that date night. It's still light, but still has like that punch to it that you need to kind of make a statement. So love these two. I've been wearing these two nonstop. I wore them throughout my whole entire vacation and I just love it. So really, really great scents. I will link the information down below so y'all can check that out. But moving on from that, down here is just my boyfriend's PS5. And yeah, this is just an overall take of the bedroom. Very, very light. Nothing's really changed at all from my other apartment tour. So yeah, let me know what y'all think down in the comments about the bedroom. Oh, I forgot to tell you about the rug. So the rug is from Ross. It was very inexpensive. It was about $80 for this like 7x9 rug, I believe it was. Yeah, it was like 7x9 or close to 8x10. So it was a very, very big rug for only $80, and it's really, really nice quality. So check out Ross for their rugs because they have some really, really nice ones. So moving on to the bathroom. So when you walk in the bathroom, you're immediately met with this beautiful shelving that I really love. I love shelving in the bathroom. I think it adds so much luxury to it. When you walk a little bit further inside, you have this really nice vanity, same quartz countertops as the kitchen, same cabinetry and everything, and a really large mirror, which I love. And then over here is just the closet. I love the double doors that lead to the closet. And then over here is just the walk-in shower with subway tile inside. Over here is just a garden tub, which is new. I didn't have a tub at my other one, so I really love how this looks so much. So yeah, let's just go ahead and dive into the details. So this is just a bathroom caddy from Vivo Home. You can check them out on Amazon. I'll link this information down below. They sent me this bathroom caddy and I always wanted one of these. I think it's so luxurious and gives so much spa vibes. I just have a candle from Home Goods on top of it with some towels. And yeah, this is definitely a must have. If you're trying to have a relaxing bathroom night, you can light a candle, put a glass of wine on here and everything. You can really dress this up to make it look as luxurious as you would like it to. So definitely check out Vivo Home. Their information will be linked down below. Over here, I just have a little dried palm from Lux B and then a Casaluna candle in the corner. So on my shelving, I normally have more towels, but they're in the wash. But I just have, you know, my Bath & Body Works collection up here, so I can just easily grab that. I just have a little basket from Home Goods at the top with extra toilet paper in it. And then just some more towels and things like that in a little basket from Target down below. On the vanity, I just have some Hello toothpaste along with a candle from Home Goods, a reed diffuser from Cash & Co, which she sent to me a couple months ago, and I really, really like it a lot. And she is a Black-owned business, so check her out. I'll put her information down below. Here is some dried palm leaves from Lux B. Love those so much. And then on this side, I just have a little tray from Home Goods with some clear jars from Hobby Lobby on there. Super inexpensive. I just have some cotton balls and cotton swabs in there. And then I have a soap dispenser, which is from Home Goods, a little candle from Public Goods, and then the napkin holder is also from Home Goods. So moving on to the shower area. So the shower door does not get as clear and clean as I would like it to. I promise it's not dirty, but this table is from Five Below. The plant is from Home Goods, and I just have some Bath & Body Works sitting on top of there, and then the little brush is also from Home Goods as well. And then my bath mats are from Target. So yeah. So let's move on to the closet. So the closet has these beautiful double doors, definitely giving luxurious vibes. You open it up and it's not the biggest closet in the world. Me and my boyfriend do share this closet, but it's really, really cute. So I try to organize it as much as possible, but I do have a lot of clothes. So we just have a lot of these little drawer shelves to kind of help us organize that. These are from Walmart for like $10. So if you're looking for some storage, that's definitely a good option for your closet. But yeah, let's talk about this Teddy Blake bag, because Teddy Blake sent me this bag about a month ago and it's gorgeous. Okay, this is my first time hearing about them and I'm so glad I did, because this bag is so nice, it's so luxurious, and you guys are gonna love it. So let's talk about it. So Teddy Blake has a team of Italian designers who create these beautiful bags. They have so many different styles, a style for everyone, literally. This style is particularly what resonated with me the most. I really love the design of this bucket bag. It's just beautiful. There are so many styles to choose from, so it's super hard to decide which one you want to get, but the pricing is super affordable for a luxury bag of this quality. So you would definitely cannot go wrong with getting more than one if you choose to, but this definitely is beautiful. It comes with a wristlet, which I love. The wristlet situation is great for me because sometimes you want to be on the go and just put a little wristlet on. And then it also came with a little crossbody strap here to attach to the bag if you want to have like a little crossbody or a side satchel situation going on as well. So this is premium leather. This is real leather, crafted to perfection. So definitely check out Teddy Blake. I will put the information down below. I believe that this brand is going to go super far. So thank you so much to Teddy Blake for sending me this beautiful bag. I highly recommend checking them out because you will not go wrong. This is luxury for the fraction of the price. Okay, so when we exit the bedroom, we're gonna go straight across to this new bedroom, which I'm so excited to show y'all because I turned it into an office space. So this is now my new office space, new oasis, chill spot, editing room, YouTube room, everything you can imagine. I'm so excited to have this because I have my own space now that I can work in and just chill. So yes, love everything about this room. So let me tell you where everything is from. So this chair right here is from TJ Maxx. I believe it was about $70. It swivels, so that's super cool. I really like the color of it. I wanted to add a pop of color since everything is so neutral in here, but I didn't want anything too loud and crazy, so I chose to go with this nice rust cognac color. This throw blanket is actually from Five Below. It was only $5. Don't sleep on Five Below, they have great things. In this corner here, just my ring light and my tripod, which is from Amazon. And then I have a very large planter down here, which is from Marshall's, and I love it. No, this pompous grass is not gonna stay in here. It's obviously too small to fit in this huge vase, but I just needed somewhere to put it for now. But this pompous grass is from Lux B. And yeah, so love, love, love that vase. I'll probably add a nice plant to it. This futon is from Walmart. It was about $280, which is not bad at all. It turns into a sleeper sofa. I wanted something that I can have to chill in, but also have somewhere where guests can sleep if they do come over to sleep. So definitely a nice find for the price. It isn't the most comfortable, but it does the job, so I'll take it. The pillows on the futon are from Amazon. They are pillow inserts, and I just have pillow covers on them. I'll link all that down below for you guys. And then here is my gallery wall, which I was able to curate myself, and I just absolutely love it. So the frames are from Golden State Art, which they sent to me a while back, and I finally was able to get some pictures from Desenio to put inside of the frame. So I'll link their information down below. These frames are gorgeous. And then they are an 11x14 and the prints are 8x11. So love, love, love this gallery wall. I'm probably gonna add a picture light at the top of it to add some luxury to it. So stay tuned, I'll keep y'all updated on all the changes I make in this room because it's still a work in process. So this rug is from Target, and then this little table here is from TJ Maxx. It was about $30, not bad at all. And then I just have an Architectural Digest book on top, as well as my Devon Franklin Success Commandments book on top. And then a aloe plant from Target. It's a faux aloe plant from Target. So love, love, love how this room is looking so far. And it's just giving me very chill and just productive and focused vibes. So over here is just a file cabinet, which is from Yada Home. You can check out Yada Home on Amazon. They have great finds. It's a very, very nice file cabinet. It was kind of difficult to assemble. It does not come assembled, so good luck with that. But this candle is from Home Goods. I really love the aesthetic of it, and I just have it sitting on top of some books The Road and the Keys by DJ Khaled. So love, love, love how that looks. Back to the file cabinet. I ended up getting some file folders just to kind of file away our papers. And I'm definitely feeling like super mom with no kids over here because I just have everything like organized. Us, the dog, papers, everything. Like, we all have a folder in there for our things. So I'm definitely feeling accomplished by doing that. But yeah, the drawers are really nice. And then the best thing about the file cabinet is that it rolls. So it has wheels on it. So you can kind of put it where you need it to go. Or if you're filing something somewhere else, you can definitely roll it to your liking. So love that file cabinet. I'll link Data Home's information down below. So yes, back here, it's just the view of the beautiful pond. Love that. So you can definitely have a very chill vibe while you're working and just enjoy the pond while you're just in your zone. So love that about it. On this side here is definitely the work in progress for sure. But I do love these shelves. These shelves are the Nathan James shelves. I got them from Walmart, but you can get them from Amazon as well. On this shelf, I just have a little pedestal bowl, which is from Ross. Very shocked to see that at Ross, and it was only like $14. So love that. Definitely a great addition to the space. This is just a little figurine from Home Goods. Over here is just Forgiving What You Can't Forget in Homebody, with the Hearth and Hand salt diffuser sitting on top of it. Love that, but it does not smell. You can't smell it. So, but it's very, very aesthetically pleasing. So I like that. Down here, it's another candle from Hearth and Hand. I don't think they sell this one anymore, but this bead is from Amazon. And then down here, it's just my printer and some notebooks and such. On this side over here, I just have a waterfall from Ferris Island. It was on my patio, but I moved it in here because I liked the sound of water while I'm working for some reason. I feel like it just zens me out. And then I just have some little dry erase to-do boards, which is from Home Goods, but they are supposed to be mounted on the wall. They're just not mounted yet. I also have a desk pad here. This is from Amazon. I'll link that down below. And I just have my laptop and mouse sitting on there. Over here in the corner is just a little pin holder, which is from Home Goods, I believe. And then this diffuser is from Target. My desk chair is from Home Goods. It was about $70, I believe. And you can extend it how far you want to. So here is my other shelf. On top of it is just a hourglass, which is from Target. And then I have another tray, which this tray came from Ross, like the pedestal bowl. And then I have a rosary that my mom gave me inside of it. Here is just a Gucci Mane book with Zara Home scented cards sitting on top of it. Down here is just a planter from Hobby Lobby, which shocked me because it's beautiful and it was only like $14. Cannot beat that. And then down here is just me and my boyfriend's little scrapbook of all of our dates from 2019. So yeah, this is just what these shelves are looking like, and this is just what the overall look of this little office space is. So love how it's coming out so far. So my desk is from FlexiSpot. FlexiSpot is a great company. They have amazing standing desk. It has an electric motor that allows the desk to rise up or down. So you can actually work standing up if you want to. So I think that's super, super cool. And I really love this desk. So thank you, FlexiSpot, for sending me this desk. I really love it. I've been using it so much. So moving on to the bathroom. This is the guest bathroom. So this bathroom is really nothing special just yet. I just kind of used what I already had so it wouldn't just be empty. This is going to be the guest bathroom for guests to come and use this one instead of using mine. So I definitely want this space to look like something eventually. So if y'all want to see a bathroom makeover, please let me know. But there is something special on this wall over here. Cecilia's House sent me this portrait, the Black Women's Manifesto, and I just love the message of it. So thank you so much to Cecilia's House for sending me this. They are a Black-owned business, so check them out. They have beautiful artwork, and I just love how they capture the essence of the Black woman. It's just beautiful. So definitely check them out. And I love the fact that the picture says, "The world needs you, sis," because we need that reminder here and there. So I absolutely love this. But down below here, I just have a basket from Five Below with some extra toilet paper in it. on the vanity here, I have this really, really nice mirror, just as big as the one, not maybe even bigger than my other mirror in my bathroom. This plant is from TJ Maxx. This soap dispenser is from Home Goods. The napkins are from Amazon. And then I just have a brown sugar scrub from Marshall's. So definitely a great little guest situation going on. Nothing too fancy. I have my shower curtain. This is from Walmart, and the rings are from Walmart as well. Very inexpensive duo going on here. And I think my favorite part about this bathroom is that it faces the kitchen, so guests can come in straight through the front of the house and I have to go through any rooms to get to the bathroom. So that's definitely a great aspect to it as well. Definitely spacious. This bathroom has a shower and tub combination, so that's great as well. And then over here in this corner is just a little closet, which we use for storage. So nothing fancy to show you guys in there. So we're just going to move on from that. So moving on out of the bathroom, oh, look at Benji. Hey, Benny. This is my puppy, Benji. He is the sweetest puppy ever. But moving on to the patio. So let me show you guys what's going on out here. So Yada Home sent me this beautiful patio set, which I am in love with. I do have a patio makeover video that I will link so you guys can check that out. But I really love this new patio setup. I think that it's just so relaxing and just so nice to be out here in these hot summer days. But I got these little stepping stools from Home Depot and just steps out to the pond. So really loving the pond. The ducks are out today. They're never here. They just randomly showed up today. So that's fun. They decided to show up and show out for y'all in this video. So back to the patio. Here is what it looks like from the grassy area. Definitely a great vibe. So I will link the video so y'all can check that out and see where everything on here is from. Okay guys, so this is the end of the video. I hope you guys love my new apartment and new decor. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe and comment down below what you think about everything. And until next time, I will see you guys later.